Talent Training Group presents Cleaning Revolvers. Visit our website, talenttraininggroup.com, for other training videos and for personal safety and firearms accessory sales. We test and evaluate all of our products and only sell what we believe in. Also, we offer concealed carry training and personal safety training in the Tallahassee, Florida area. Cleaning revolvers is a fairly simple process. This is a Smith & Wesson Model 686 stainless gun. Makes it a little bit easier to clean. They tend to hold up a little better than blued guns. To open the weapon, you just press forward on the latch of the catch, push the cylinder out, spin it, and make sure that all of the holes in the cylinder, all the individual chambers, are empty. And inspect the weapon and make sure there are no barrel obstructions or anything else on the weapon that might cause any problems. Next, start with a patch, clean patch. Pull one corner through a slotted jag and fold the patch over. It tends to cover up the middle part of the jag. Makes this tool pretty useful. Put some solvent. Soak this patch pretty good. You're going to wet a lot of this pistol. And run this wet patch through each of the holes in your cylinder. Just poke it through. You just want to get some of the solvent in there so it can start eating away at this grime. You're going to do the barrel the same way. You want to get some of this down in the barrel. Might use a clean patch to start that out with. Revolvers are pretty filthy shooting weapons. There's gases escape around the end of the cylinder there where the bullet leaps across that tiny gap into the barrel. So a lot of gases escape there and makes the weapon kind of dirty. Semi-automatic tends to be a bit cleaner firing, and if you're shooting lead ammo through a revolver, you're going to get a lot more dirt and grime. Jacketed ammo or semi-jacketed ammunition is a lot cleaner shooting on these weapons. Anyway, take a clean patch, run some solvent down your barrel, and try to get everything wet. The patch technique I use when I'm cleaning is generally just a corner of the patch through the slot, and then I can push the jag through, and as I pull it back, I'm getting both sides of that patch pushing against the metal surface. So I can, you're basically getting using the patch twice, but you're only using one side of it each time. Anyway, take a bronze bristle bore brush. I try not to use stainless on stainless steel or anything else. The bronze, or phosphor bronze, about $1 a piece. It's the best kind of brush to use. Press the brush through the barrel and pull it back out. Try not to reverse the brush while it's in the barrel. Push it all the way through so you can see it come out the far side, and then pull it back out. You can do it 4, 5, 6 times, depending on how often you shoot the weapon. Next, take the same brush and you want to run it through each of the holes in your cylinder. The dirtiest part of this is going to be at the far end of the hole there where the round sets, as that round starts to leave the casing. It leaves some marks there and some dirt. As you look down in there, you can see where that is. You just want to make sure you clean as best you can. Then I'd move to a nylon bristle brush and put some solvent on. I use CLP. Some more aggressive solvents sometimes are easier to clean these guns, but you want to run this brush, scrub it pretty hard around the entry of the chamber here, and also on the back where the firing pin comes out of the frame, and down here where the neck is, this hinge, and the front of the cylinder. That gets pretty dirty. A lot of people use wire brushes here, and if your gun's really, really dirty, you might do that. Some 3 or 4 ounce steel wool sometimes with some lube on it. If you've got stuff that's really stubborn and won't come off, you can use that. That tends not to scratch. A good rust removing technique is to, if you got a little bit of rust on a blued surface, is to take some 4 ounce steel wool with some gun oil and rub it until the rust comes off. And you got to be careful with that because it will remove blue, a blued finish eventually. Anyway, scrub this gun down, make sure it's clean. I mean, you'll know when it's clean. You just watch it. And I like these double-ended toothbrushes. They these gun cleaning brushes. They're only a few bucks. And clean the hammer. You can cock the hammer, clean around it, clean down in there. You can blow out some of these areas with some air, compressed air. I use the computer keyboard cleaning air. It comes in a can. It's a few dollars a can. If you don't have an air compressor, it works pretty good. Then take your clean patches, push it through the barrel, pull it back. You use my method. Put a clean patch on, and you'll go through the barrel with clean patches again and again until they come out clean. And then you're going to do the same thing with the cylinder and make sure that that it's clean. You'll go through some patches. You can get patches in bulk. The Brownells sells them. Your gun shops will sell them. You can take t-shirts, cut them up. Old t-shirts work really well. Just cut them into small squares. Have bigger squares for your 45s and smaller squares for your 9s. Just, you know, if you get one with a lot of lint, you want to make sure you don't leave a lot of lint on your weapon when you're done. Especially some shirts. Old flannel shirts work really well too, but they tend to have a lot of threads come off of them and stay in the gun. Especially if you're cleaning rifles, you certainly don't want those threads in your chambers because they can kind of mess up your chamber. I've seen rifle rounds come out where it actually had thread indentations in the casing afterwards. It's very intense pressure there. You don't have that problem with these weapons. They tend to just collect grime, which collects moisture, which causes corrosion over time. These guns aren't cheap. Don't want to let them get too bad. Anyway, another way to clean the weapon is use some gun scrubber, Rusty Duck, or spray solvents from Remington or some of the other places, and you can really, really, really clean these things with that. If you use this stuff, you're going to want to lube it really well after you're done. This is kind of like brake cleaner. Do not use brake cleaner. It's got acetone. It softens plastic parts. Don't use anything with acetone in it. But things designed to clean guns work fine. Compressed air will clean this stuff off. It evaporates pretty quick. And then just wipe your weapon back down. If you use a spray solvent, sometimes it'll pull stuff out of areas you wouldn't normally get clean. So you want to wipe back in here pretty good after you're done. Then you want to use some patches to clean back in here again, especially if you use a spray solvent. Just make sure everything's clean. Give it a good going over. And then you want to lube it. I like a heavier gun oil, but Rem oil or the Hoppy's products work pretty good. If you use the lighter oils like that, you'll want to check it every once in a while. Tetra products, CLP, tend to be a little heavier oil. On this plunger, you want to push it through. Make sure there's some oil inside the cylinder so that it operates freely and that it spins. Put some on the end of the plunger and push it through. That'll cover that surface. Then your catch, make sure that it operates freely. I'll cock the hammer, put a drop of oil down where the hammer pivot pin is going to be, work the action a few times, maybe a drop down on the hinge where the neck joins the frame. Pretty much anywhere there's a moving part. Not a lot of moving parts here that's visible without taking the grips off the gun. But obviously, if you want to take the screw out of the grip and look down in there, you can clean that too, but it's not typically needed. Anyway, give the gun a good wiping down. Blued gun's a little better than stainless, but cock it, pull the trigger a few times, make sure it's good, and you're done. And make sure you visit talonttraininggroup.com for more training videos as we our library grows, and also for our upcoming concealed carry classes and our personal safety classes. Also product sales. Our catalog is continuing to grow, and we'll begin to carry more items that we've tested and recommend.